Hello and good day to you. We are Group A, and today we are going to be tackling hegemony, which includes its concept along with another word, interpolation. So, having said that, let's now get started.
First, we'll be talking about Antonio Gramsci and his background. Antonio Gramsci, born on the 23rd of January in 1891 in Alice, Sardinia, Italy, and died on the 27th of April in 1937 in Rome. Antonio Gramsci was an intellectual and politician. He was a founder of the Italian Communist Party called the Democrats of the Left, whose ideas significantly impacted Italian communism. Amid World War I, he studied Marxist thought and got to be a leading theoretician. He shaped a leftist group inside the Communist Party and established the daily paper called L'Ordine Nuovo, or The New Order, in May 1919. Gramsci driven a leftist walkout at the Socialist Congress at Livorno, Italy in January 1921 to found the Italian Communist Party, also known as the Democrats of the Left, and then spent 2 years within the Soviet Union. Back in Italy, he became head of his party in April 1924 and was chosen to the country's Chamber of Deputies. After that, he was arrested, and due to his poor health, he died shortly after his release. But the remains of Gramsci's prison writings were distributed for the first time within the mid-20th century. His Quaderni del Carcere, or also known as prison notebooks, showed up in 1975. His numerous propositions became an essential part of Western Marxist thought and influenced the post-World War II strategies of communist parties within the West. And that will be all for my part. Next, we'll be talking about hegemony.
So the intellectual Antonio Gramsci was actually the one who developed the notion of hegemony. In fact, he was most known for his theory around cultural hegemony, in which describes the bourgeoisie using cultural institutions to maintain power over capitalist societies. But what is hegemony? Well, hegemony is the dominance of one group over another. It usually refers to the relationships between countries. The word hegemony derives from the Greek word hegemon, which means leader or simply dominance over. Hegemony is either attained through military strength, political influence, or the economy. There exists about three forms of hegemony, namely regional, monetary, and cultural. Starting with regional hegemony, this refers to the influence of a country over others within a region. So let's take the American region. The hegemon would obviously be the United States, and for East Asia, it would be China. As for Europe, though, it would be Germany despite being smaller than Russia. They hold their place as hegemon due to their economic status. Next is monetary hegemony. This refers to the dominance over an operation of an international monetary system. In simpler words, this means having control over the economy, whether it be in a state, the country, or globally. This means they have access to the international credits and the foreign exchange market. When you think of globally accepted currency, you think of the US dollar. Despite it having less value than the Kuwaiti dinar, they are still the key currency when it comes to being the medium for international exchange. And that's where the United States stays as the hegemon of the entire world. And lastly, the cultural hegemony. This refers to the dominance over a culturally diverse society, in which the ruling class or hegemons manipulate the beliefs, morals, and values of the group below them, eventually changing their norms as well. But this has to be done indirectly because you can't just force these ideas onto someone and expect them to change their mind. So they have to do it subtly and through the use of media to accomplish it. Gramsci distinguished hegemony based on two things: coercion and consensus. Coercion uses direct force and deploys institutions tasked with exercising instruments that exhibits and implements force. This caters to the political society of the state. While consensus is a form of control where individuals voluntarily assimilate the hegemony of the dominant group, which basically means that they accept the fact that they are being, they have a group showing dominance over them. And this is actually more favorable and more effective of the two between coercion and consensus due to the fact that it caters to the civil society of the state. But of course, in the Gramscian concept of the state, you would need both the political society and the civil society in order to complete the state. So you'd have to use both coercion and consensus, while at the same time giving more priority to the consensus.
Hi, I'm Giorgio, and I'm going to talk about Louis Althusser. So who is Louis Althusser? Louis Althusser is a French Marxist philosopher. He is famous for attempting to fuse the ideology of Marxism and structuralism. He was a longtime and sometimes a strong critic of the French Communist Party. So now let us talk about his background. Louis Althusser was born on October 16, 1918 in Algeria. He is named after his uncle who was killed in action during the First World War. After the death of his father, he moved to France. He joined the Catholic Youth Movement in 1937. As a student, he performed brilliantly in school. He was accepted in one of the elite schools in Paris, France, but he has to postpone studying there because he was enlisted during the Second World War. And he became interested in the ideology of communism when he was captured by the Nazis. After the war, he finally attended the school, but his mental and physical shape was too poor. He joined the French Communist Party in 1948. In 1980, he suffered from a mental breakdown where he murdered his own wife and was sent to a psychiatric hospital and was hospitalized for 3 years. And later on, he passed away at the age of 72 in France. Now let us talk about his works. So as I said earlier, he is famous for fusing Marxism and structuralism. But his other famous works include For Marx, which is written in 1965, Reading Capital in 1965, and The Ideology and the Ideological State Apparatuses.
Interpolation. Louis Pierre Althusser, 1918 to 1990, was a French Marxist philosopher who introduced the term interpolation, a process by which individuals are constituted as subjects, a process in which we encounter our culture's value and internalize them. It expresses the idea that is not simply yours alone, but has been presented to you for you to accept. For example, when a teacher addresses a class as students, The people on those settings are being asked to adopt a subject position or subject role that is beneficial to maintaining social order. Althusser believes that we cannot resist the process of interpolation. Many theorists have taken Althusser's notion of ideology and interpolation, shifted the focus away from the state, and applied it to various kinds of media texts. Cultural theorists such as Max Horkheimer and Theodor Adorno insisted that the persistence of some tropes turned the audience into passive subjects. They stated, immovably, they insist on the very ideology which enslaves them, the misplaced love of the common people for the wrong which is done them is a greater force than the cunning of the authorities. When a person interacts with a media text, for example, when we like a magazine or TV show, this uncritical consumption indicates that the text has interpolated us into a set of assumptions and caused us to tacitly accept a certain approach to the world, explains David Gauntlet. Here, Gauntlet seemed to echo Adorno and Horkheimer's argument that media consumers unquestioningly accept a medium subject positioning of them as passive viewers. Interpolation works in a manner much like giving a person a name or calling out to them in the streets. That is, ideologies address people and offer them a particular identity which they are encouraged to accept. However, one is not forced to accept that role through violence.
Now, to summarize, hegemony is the dominance of one group over other groups. Hegemony itself has three types of forms, the first being regional, the second being monetary, and the last being cultural. Hegemony, in addition, can be distinguished between coercion and consensus, where coercion means the use or application of direct forces, while consensus, on the other hand, is the voluntarily assimilation of hegemony of a dominant group. Now, as for interpolation, in short, is somewhat the ideology embedded in media texts that is then passed on to the audiences, which then makes them a new subject. Thank you for watching our video. Now, if you would like to see more of these types of videos, then please do subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell for updates. Also, don't forget to comment down below to let us know what you think. Now, once again, we are Group 8 and signing out.